Hello students, welcome to our National Public School online classes. We are dealing with chemistry chapter that is materials, metals and non-metals. So under this chapter, we were studying about the different reactions, that is reaction with the oxygen, reaction with the water, displacement reaction in the last section we have studied along with the experimental demonstration, reaction with the bases. Now we shall study about the reaction with the acids. So in order to study the reaction of the acids, here we are taking different samples, that is both non-metal as well as the metal. And see here, whether it reacts with the acids, if it is reacting, then what will be the sort of the reaction and all. So here, in this reaction with the acids, here four samples we are taken. One is aluminium. So aluminium, no doubt it is a metal. Then sulfur powder. Sulfur is a non-metal, then charcoal, it is also a non-metal, along with it are taken iron filings. So here two have taken the metals and two non-metal, and see here what is the reaction of the acid. So here the acid I have taken, it is the dilute sulfuric acid. Now let us know here what will be the reaction of the acid on these metal and the non-metal. So you can record your observations. Now we shall do this experiment and see the reactions. So here we have taken, this is the charcoal powder, in the second aluminium foil, and the third copper turnings, and the fourth is the iron filings. So these are the copper turnings as well as the iron filing. So this is the acid, this is the dilute sulfuric acid we have taken in the container. Now here one by one we shall put these samples into the beakers and then add the acid, and then you can see the reactions and record your observations. So now we are taking the charcoal powder in the first container. So charcoal, it is the non-metal. Then here I am taking silver foil or aluminium foil. Next in the third, copper turnings. Next in the fourth, iron filings. Now in the four containers we have taken the sample. So charcoal, it is a non-metal. Silver foil or aluminium foil, it is the metal. So here copper turnings, it is also a metal. Iron filings, it is also a metal. So here I have taken three samples, metal and one non-metal. So this is the dilute sulfuric acid. I have diluted the concentrated sulfuric acid. Now I add to this one, record your observations. You can see no reaction. So this shows that non-metals are non-reactive with acids. Next here I am adding acid to the silver foil. Next here I am adding to the copper turnings. Next year, iron filings. So here you can see the formation of bubbles. It shows that metal is reacting with the acid. So very fine bubbles are coming.
with a very hissing sound. So children, record your observation that when acid is added to the iron filings, bubbles are released. And in this also, so many bubbles are getting released, showing that copper being the metal, it is also reacting. So here also, there is the formation of the bubbles. But here, charcoal being the non-metal, it is not reacting with the acid. So this shows that metals reacts with the acids, non-metals are non-reactive with the acid.
So dear students, now we have observed that reaction. So still here the fumes are coming. So these fumes are nothing but the hydrogen. This shows that whenever metals reacts with acid, it results in the formation of hydrogen gas. So this is one of the common general concept what we know. Whenever the metals reacts with the acid, it will result in the liberation of hydrogen gas. But the hydrogen will not get released when non-metals react with the acid. So by demonstration also you have observed, you can record the observation. So dear students, now you have observed and studied in detail what are the chemical properties of metals and non-metal. So here reaction with oxygen, only metals will react with oxygen. Non-metals, they are non-reactive. Reaction with the water, that is a rusting of iron. Displacement reaction. So one example here studied, whenever we take copper sulfate and drop iron lead, it results in the formation of ferrous sulfate displacing the copper. So this is also one of the exclusive example for displacement reaction. Then reaction with the bases. So here also, if we take sodium hydroxide and drop aluminium foil into this one, it also releases the hydrogen gas. So resulting that, indicating that whenever the bases reacts with the metals, then also hydrogen gas get released. Now reaction with acids, just now you have observed that whenever the metals reacts with the acid, it results in the liberation of hydrogen gas. And also you have studied the uses of the metals and non-metal, right from one small pin to the aeroplane, aircraft and also spacecraft. Everywhere we are using the metals as well as the non-metals. So this is about the a very good interesting information about the materials, metals and non-metal. So this completes the chapter. In the next class we shall meet you in the